Hello, welcome to our short video on how to design a low-side bidirectional current sensing circuit. This schematic represents a single supply low-side bidirectional current sensing circuit. Current sensing circuits are used to convert and amplify an input current, also known as a load current, to an output voltage. This circuit is called low-side because the sense resistor, R shunt, is connected to ground. Bidirectional means that the load current, I sub I, can flow in both the positive direction or negative direction. To convert the load current to a voltage, a difference amplifier circuit with a reference voltage, Vref, is used. The reference voltage biases the output of the circuit to mid-supply to allow for both positive and negative load currents. Note that there are other ways to perform this type of current sensing, such as using a current sense amplifier. The transfer function of this circuit is composed of three parts. First, the sense resistor, or R shunt, converts the load current, I sub I, into a voltage based on the value of its resistance. This voltage is called the shunt voltage, or V shunt. V shunt is then amplified by the gain of the difference amplifier, which simplifies to R4 divided by R3 when R1 is equal to R3 and R2 is equal to R4. Lastly, the reference voltage biases up the output voltage to mid-supply since the load current is symmetrical. The first design goal of this circuit is to convert a maximum input current of 1 amp to a maximum output voltage of 3.19 volts and a minimum load current of minus 1 amp to a minimum output voltage of 110 millivolts. In low-side current sensing applications, it's common to set the maximum shunt voltage so that the load's ground potential is nearly equal to that of the op-amp and ADC. In this circuit, the maximum shunt voltage, V shunt, is set to 100 millivolts. Lastly, a reference voltage of 1.65 volts is required to bias up the output of the amplifier. The first design step is to calculate the maximum shunt resistance, R shunt, based on the maximum load current of 1 amp and maximum shunt voltage of 100 millivolts. To do this, we divide the maximum shunt voltage by the maximum load current, which yields a value for R shunt of 100 milliohms. The next step is to calculate the gain of the circuit, which is calculated by dividing the output voltage swing by the input voltage swing. Remember that the input voltage of this circuit is equal to the load current times R shunt. So the gain is calculated by the output voltage swing divided by the load current range times R shunt. The gain of the circuit is R4 divided by R3 because we set R1 equal to R3 and R2 equal to R4. Choosing a standard resistor value of 1.3 kiloohms for R3 allows us to calculate a resistor value of 20.15 kiloohms for R4 to give us a gain of 15.5 volts per volt. Since 20.15 kiloohms is not a standard resistor value, we will use the next closest standard resistor value of 20 kiloohms. Given a standard value of 20 kiloohms for R4 and 1.3 kiloohms for R3, the actual gain of the circuit is 15.38 volts per volt. The last step is to design the reference voltage for the circuit. The reference voltage is created by dividing down the supply voltage, VCC, with R5 and R6. The reference voltage is then buffered to provide a low impedance supply to the circuit. Since we want the output to be biased to mid-supply, we will set R5 equal to R6 to provide a reference voltage of VCC over 2, or 1.65 volts. In this simulation, a DC sweep of the input current from negative 1 amp to 1 amp yields an output voltage from 121 millivolts to 3.2 volts, centered around the reference voltage of 1.65 volts. This verifies the functionality of the circuit. Running an AC sweep analysis, we find that the bandwidth of the circuit is 77 kHz. When designing a low-side bidirectional current sensing amplifier circuit, there are a few design notes to be aware of. First, be sure to use an op-amp whose common mode voltage, or VCM, includes ground. Next, be sure to always check the linear output swing of the amplifier, which is usually given in the conditions column of the AOL, or open loop gain, data sheet specification. Finally, be sure to buffer the voltage divider to provide a low impedance node to the reference voltage, VREF. Texas Instruments has many online resources to help you design circuits with op amps. These include reference designs and guides, educational videos, simulation and prototyping tools, support resources, and search tools. Thank you for taking the time to watch this short presentation on how to design a low-side, bidirectional current sensing circuit. Please visit www.ti.com for additional information and resources.